Good morning, I'm Benjamin.
And I'm Emily. Today's date is Monday, April 14th, 2014.
It's the 143rd day of school.
The weather today will be a high of 72, a low of 60, and a low of 62 with rainy skies.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance and the singing of the Star Spangled Banner.
Next, we will pause for a moment of silent reflection.
Attention, salute, pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Now to our interviewers, Paula and Mackenzie, and our special guest, Mr. Singer.
Good morning, Mr. Singer. Welcome to GBTV.
Good morning. How are you?
Good.
Good morning. How are you?
Good.
Awesome. Thank you. Good morning, GBTV crew. Good morning, Gators. Happy Monday. It's a rainy Monday, but we're not going to let that deter us from meeting our expectations of being safe, respectful, responsible, and resourceful. We'll start off with our lunch menu on this meatless Monday. I'll hold up the sign as you read.
Our lunch today is pizza stuffed crust cheese, bean tostada, pita chips, fruit yogurt salad, steamed fresh cauliflower, sweet potato, fresh apples, and mandarin oranges.
Okay, so as you're making your meatless Monday selections, please be sure to choose wisely. That's a good lunch menu, actually. I want to hear what you think about it later on, today and tomorrow. But as you're making your selections, please choose wisely because what you receive today, what you choose this morning, will be what you receive this afternoon or during your lunch hour. Be respectful of one another. Enjoy your lunchtime. Also want to make sure, is this annoying? Do you like this?
Yeah.
This is nice. This is nice. Want to make sure that you enjoy your meal. Make sure that you are taking your tray up individually. Don't have to go up as a group. That actually helps with the flow of traffic. Okay, I'm putting it down then. We have a wondrous word. Our wondrous word is
agricultural.
Agricultural. It's a fun word to say. Agricultural. Our wondrous word agricultural comes to us courtesy of Kaylin, Madeline, and Charlene, all second graders from Mr. Mack's class, Mr. McLevane. They found the word agricultural in a book entitled Butterflies, Blooms, and Bees. Butterflies, Blooms, and Bees. Either of you have ever heard of the title before? Interesting title, new title for some. They found the word in the following sentence. In Minnesota, where bookkeepers like to rest their bees near clover, fewer wild clover exist as the state's agricultural region has become an even more vast sea of corn and soybeans. It's a lengthy sentence, very informative. In the Minnesota, where bookkeepers like to rest their bees, I think that might be beekeepers, I'm looking at it wrong. Beekeepers like to rest their bees near clover. Fewer wild clover exist as the state's agricultural region has become an even more vast sea of corn and soybeans. Agricultural region there. I'm thinking. Did the second graders select this book because they're working on butterfly projects? And I'm wondering, what do beekeepers have to do with their butterfly project? Are they working on bees as well? Did you know that Minnesota was this big agricultural region, a vast sea of corn and soybeans? All questions I'll have to ask these ladies when I see them today in Mr. McElvain's class. From the way the word is used in the sentence, they believe that agricultural means their temporary home. Their temporary home. The definition for agricultural is?
Related to farming.
So this is a farming area in Minnesota. And from the way the word is used in the sentence, the wild clover that used to be there, that would grow there on its own, that land is being taken over for the agriculture and the development of corn and soybeans. So I wonder what the implications for this will be for the bees who used to go there for the nectar from the clover. Very good word. Very good wondrous words. Keep the wondrous words coming. You know how much I enjoy watching our wondrous word wall grow. And that's attributed to your looking through your novels and finding those words. And what's happening is some of my gators are letting me know that they're seeing those words in their novels. And it helps to enhance their understanding of what they're reading. So great job, gators. That's all I have for this morning, ladies.
Thanks for visiting us on GBTV. Now back to our anchors, Emily and Benjamin.
S3R.
Have a great gator day.
Bye.
Nothing better than I'm a candy, all wrapped in a sweat. Someday soon I'll make you mine, and then I love candy all the time. Ooh, I
All right.